Hello and welcome to Dell's Gaming. I'm Dell and this is Prisoner Architect Alpha35. Keep on having to remember. And we're just continuing on where we left off. Now, I have done a little bit of work in the meantime just to go through some of the changes. Some of the things I have found that were not working properly and some of the changes we've got to make. And also some of the items that has to be taken into account when you're building your own prisons, which I didn't when I started this particular prison. First of all, access to visitor areas. Now, if we go to the deployment, it'll be easier. I'll just minimize this for a second. Although these areas are shared, the parole and the visitors, if a visitor in, say, the medium sec family comes through, because there is no pathway through, they are unable to use this visitation area. So the option would be to have make all of these areas shared, which means you get a lot of mingling of all your various people, different security levels, which is something I wanted to stay away from on this particular map. Or you have to create some another idea I had was create some corridors to a central shared area where the parole visitation was, where people can get to, which is still a possibility. And I'm sort of split on that idea as a maybe an alternative as well. Or you have to create a visitor area, a parole area, and all these other functions in the relative security zone for each of the systems and areas. So that's so what I did do was create a visitor table here. So this is the medium security visitor area. I also, you may have seen on deployment, made this min security, so they will actually use this to get to this area. And what I can actually do is do that as well, so they can actually get here to use that area. We've luckily got making this min security right next to the main door would be a bit of a problem, except I'm happy that we've got two barriers and a whole load of fences, so generally I'm sort of fairly happy about that. Okay, other bits I did is down in our new maximum security, we've got the same situation here in that for people to reuse areas, they have to have a path through. So what I've done, or decided to do, is that we're going to make some shared areas. We're going to try and segregate our max security as much as possible into the main areas. So the three starting points will be the cells, segregated into small groups, the yard, separate for that group, and the kitchen, canteen, separated for each of those groups, and the shower block will be in here as well. So under our regime for maximum security, that will cover sleep, shower, eat, not free time, but yard. So the only time we're gonna have them mixing is going to be free time, which hopefully they won't get much time. They'll effectively won't get much time to congregate together, and work time. Now, another annoying thing is I can't set maximum security separate from normal security. I can do minimum differently and protective differently, but not these two, which is a little annoying. The other decision I made was what we're going to use with these extra rooms for. And because we're going to have shared areas, because they're going to have to each have their own, we've got visitor area, and this will be a visitor room, but they'll also have to have areas such as a library, workshop, etc., etc. On each of the extra blocks that I create, which will be duplicates of this, we'll create a the various extra rooms in those particular areas. So that's hopefully what will be happening there. We'll create some of the larger areas, like a chapel, I think we'll create down here. Okay, where else have we got? That's the main changes that I did do. Let's put it back into normal mode. Now, since it's night time, let's just give some places a shakedown. I haven't shut. Let's search this cell block just to find out what's going on. I'm gonna search the high security here. Whoop. Search cell block. Yep. And who should we else should we give a quick search to? This is just a random search function, so I'm gonna go up here actually and search that cell block. And finally, protective custody. Where are people in the protective custody? Let's give them a quick search through as well. Okay, so that's giving them all of getting our guards busy. So next on our little plan is the cells for maximum security. So I'd like to get the MaxSec moved from this temporary zone here down into this zone over here. So I started creating some items that I can clone. The other test was for this was to make sure that our video camera will do a full turn. And as you can see, it is doing a full turn. I was worried if I put bits of concrete either side, it would no longer turn correctly. But it seems to be fine. So we are going to now just set these rooms up. So they are ready for use. So they should all be now. Are they all done? Yeah, they are all done. Okay. Right, now we can use the clone tool. Okay, clone. There we go. Now I've got to allow a little bit of room for the shower, so I'm just going to do that number first and then do the same for this one. Just to get them cloning and working. Now the automated door, the other idea I've got here is we're going to minimize guards in this area. As much as possible, guards will not be allowed into this zone unless absolutely necessary. Right, this is going to be the shower area, I think. Let's just mark that off with a couple of drains here. There we go, and some shower heads around. And we'll do the same on the opposite. Possibly, you know, actually it's pity that the clone can't do a mirror. That'd be nice. Is that side, is it different? No. Just funny thing, it's just me having a moment. Okay, and we've got one room available at the end, which we could make into a slightly larger cell. Or the common room. I think that's that would be the common room. Is there a limit as to the size of the common room? I.e. there's a minimum size. Where's common room? You know what? As usual, I can't see the damn thing just when I'm looking for it. Common room. No, it doesn't show any particular size, so that's cool. What we will do is just create something here. Here, like that. Same over here. And we'll just put a normal, because it does like it doors. That's the other thing we have found in here is you can't put things without doors very often. So rooms, let's go back to here. So we have our shower area. We'll be there and there, and our common room. Where's our common room? I had it here a second ago. There we go. We'll be from there. No. Yep, that is right. That is right. And there. Okay, that's excellent. Now, hopefully, eventually, these guys will be moved down. So, I've got an injured person there. They do like their fighting. That might be one other thing I've got to do. A change I noticed. The doctors seem to be working a lot better. going further afield to injure people, but it's still not far from ideal. A closer infirmary may be another ideal, you know, just a small place where a doctor can be would be handy in each case. Doesn't need much, just one bed. But a closer, that's one thing we might put down here as an infirmary. Excuse me. Just to pick up anybody in any of these areas that need a bit of help as such. So we might make one of these an infirmary and one a chapel. I'll have a look. I might make the bottom one here a chapel and put an infirmary somewhere near the top to cover. So the reason it's near the top is so it's close to these areas. Okay, that's getting through. I'm liking the remote doors. Now, one problem I have noticed is if our guy that's stationed on the remote door decides he's a bit tired, he'll go wandering off all the way up to the staff room up the top here. And it takes a while for someone to get stationed back here, which means that occasionally there's no one stationed here and therefore no one's looking after anything, which is annoying as such, to say the least. A bit of a problem. Right, let's just make sure, see how our deployment, has it got everything marked? Yes, this is MaxSec. There we go. It's heading down the right way. So now let's see, logistics, food distribution. So yeah, you're going to be going to there, there to there, there to there. Absolutely fine. That's cool. Exactly what I am after. We have, we're still waiting for a little bit of work to be done here, but never mind, that's taken over. Okay, so while we're waiting for that to be completed, what we will look at is, there was another bit that I saw. This is an important part, we're just getting to that point, is food distribution. Because this can be a problem. Now, if you go to the logistics and food distribution, you can see currently, while they're in eat mode, the supply and demand. So as you can see up here, we've got a higher demand than is being supplied at this time. Now what I've noticed is a lot of it is because of the carrying time. You can see how they're carrying the items from the canteen to there. So what I might do is here, what you can do is if you can find a kitchen which is closer, put them into there just so that they'll supply a few more, because they'll be able to quickly get over there and supply the demand. Also, it was the number of... Here, so here we're fine. Demand 0, 0. So these guys should really supply a little bit more into here and possibly here. Here the demand is just not getting enough cooks in onto the tables. Demand 15, supply... We've got 6 at the moment available. Demand 9 plus 1. Now I've got one guy who must be who's starving here for some reason. And I'm not sure why. Now he's either keeps on missing the food. He also seems to never be healed by any of our infirmary staff. Which is also another problem. We'll send one of our guys over. There we go. Where were we? Logistics, food distribution. But we can measure. So now they've gone into free time. You can see how much food was left. So actually there was spare up here, actually. But down here, it's actually showing 4 spare. So there was some demand. Now maybe they just didn't eat it. But looking at the food distribution, you can tell A, where are kitchen supplies also enough? Now, what I did increase, where's my staff? My number of cooks. Because quite simply, I noticed that it was better to have more cooks they could carry the food, go and pick up the food from the lorries a little quicker, and also deliver the food to the various places. Otherwise, you know, it's not a matter of one cook per oven. I'm more heading towards two cooks per oven. Seems to be a better ratio. So you've got one that's cooking and one which is fetching and carrying the various plates. So that's something that I noticed with that little that particular section. Right, now we're just about ready with our cells here. I think we're enough to be able to bring them in. So what we're going to do is we're going to change the this section here to once again be a MinSec. Which should now I can also change the deployment as far as guards go. Where's it? Guards. Right, because we can take out most of those. Right, during eat time, we just have the two people there. During sleep time, just the one. During work time, what's that? We just have the one as well. Okay, that's fine. That looks a little bit better. So they're all now getting moved into the new section down below, which is good. They're getting moved into these this holding cell, not holding cells, but the new cells down here. Excellent. Now, one thing before I go any further, I want to see who's assigned to which canteen, etc. here. So if we go logistics, food distribution. Now, this cell I want to go into here. There we go. That one goes into there. Yep. Nah. There. It's just assigning who goes into which canteen. This canteen is possibly not big enough, actually. Right, that looks fine. And to there. Okay, we are all okay there. There's no choice on those ones. No choice on those. There's a little bit of a choice, but not too much. And we're going to make sure that one is set to here, and this one is set to there. Excellent. Right, deployment. Right, so we have our new intake of max security prisoners, and we have a capacity at the moment of 10. Because we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We now have 8. We should eventually end up with 16. We currently have... we've got 13 capacity at the moment. We've currently got 10. Looks like I'll go put some utilities in for the showers here. Something I obviously missed. On both sides. There we go. Now, deployments. Now, I'm trying to keep these segregated as much as possible and try and keep guards out of there, except maybe at sleep. During a sleep, I think we will put a guard in each one just to try and spot anyone that might be trying to, tunnel out. But when those guards are not in there, default will be to go into this area here. So we're going to have three in the security zone, ready to react to any problem. The other issue will then be during feed times. Now, again, we're not going to put guards into these areas unless absolutely necessary. What we're going to use is the CCTV, the remote doors, to control it all. So, okay, the other side will be when there is work to be done. So during work time, we will need someone. We will look at, once we've got a, we'll possibly put someone in the workshop. But again, we're going to try and do it with CCTV wherever possible. Right, people are on work, but there is no actual work for these guys to do at the moment. So they do tend to wander around at this time. And we don't see where they wander around to. This is the time when they will be basically trying to find a route to somewhere and possibly doing they could get into trouble. Well, we're going to try and keep the visibility maximized as much as we can here. Now, where's our guy gone to open up this door? Why is he not in this area? I don't know where he is, but these are stationed here. Maybe I should open that up. Okay, let's change this deployment. Let's take one out of there and by default have one out there and have two in there. Let me just check that through. Yeah, okay, so normally we'll have three in there, but during work time when they have this wandering around, we'll put a few more into this section rather than the security. Okay. Right, next, what we're going to do is we're going to clone this whole block. We're going to do a large cloning here. So if I just, I think that... Oh, is there a limit as to how much we can clone? Oh, that's annoying. That's a pity. Okay. We will not be able to clone it just like that. Okay, let's see if I can clone the other part of it. Will you allow me to clone here? No, okay, let's clone. How much can I clone? Not quite. No. Okay. Okay, we won't be able to do the cloning then. Okay, so we're going to have to do this... I'll say the old-fashioned way. I'm going to do this by making sure I get everything right in the first place. So, in actual fact, before I do anything, let's just check this size. That is, we're going to take it down to there, 21 by 16. That's 21 by 16. We're going to make it as close as we can to being the same. Right, so a level there. 20. All right, showing 22. So 16 or 17 then. Does that look right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 17, yes. Okay, well, we're going for that. Okay, now I have to put a door in here initially. What I'm going to do is just put in some normal doors. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, going down 5. And then we'll change them over for the remote and everything else once the other parts have actually been created. So in this section, we have this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, going down to here, right next to this door. Hopefully that looks okay. So it should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the center. 4, 5 be 5. Okay, that's cool. And then over here, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 13 wide. So we start from here. And that's a little easier to do. Now, I did notice on the bottom it's got to go down one extra just so that it's exactly the same. Oops. Doesn't like that. Okay, so let's just try to do this in a couple of segments. Then we'll sort out the walls afterwards. Now I could actually put a one gap here between these things, or use this wall actually. So before I go too far, actually, I'm going to cancel that. I know, yes, that's stupid, isn't it? But when you look at it, if I do this correctly, I can use this wall just to save some space around these. So hang on a second, let's just work this out correctly, what I actually need. So if I demolish that wall there, and then do foundations, concrete, going from here, there, going down by 16, there, yes, that should be fine. And we need a door. And we put the door in, except, is that going to give enough room for this yard here? It's not, is it? Because this door sticks, this yard here sticks out. Or will it? Will it? Will it? As long as I copy that one up there, down to here, although it sticks out a little, I should be okay. Let's see if that's going to work. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, so wall. No, it's not going to quite fit in. Actually, my original plan was actually still valid. Although I lose a bit, one block of space, it was still a valid plan. Okay, that's a pity I went back on that. Oh well, let's start again. Start again, boy. Start again. We'll put that bit of fence back there. There we go. Right, okay, so that's there. We'll put those doors back in. Dismantle that door and that door. Foundation. Having a moment here. It's a stressful day at the moment. Got a lot of things I'm trying to get done at this moment, and it appears to not to be working as I would like. So okay, just to get this working, let's just put that there. Right, foundations, concrete, we'll go from here down there. No, too much. To there. That has saved a little up there. If we get a little bit of extra space there, that's fine. Not unhappy with that. And here, we shall go from here to there. There we go. That should create one nice large area for us. And then we can start, once that's done, I'll speed up for, we can start signing. Now, something else we can do whilst that's waiting. Chapel. And we've got a few areas over here we need to do. One is a chapel. Now, I might put the chapel down at the bottom, because at the top I'm going to put staff room, some places for our staff, so that all of these people don't go all the way up here to have a rest. So we're going to put an infirmary and a staff room in here, and we're going to do the same as we did below. Okay, let's see, objects. We're going to first of all dismantle this door, and then we'll put a staff door into it. Now, in infirmary, how big is the infirmary got to be? Infirmary. I think initially you only need one bed. One medical bed. So objects, let's just get a medical bed. Medical bed. And we'll just put it there, quite simply. Because we only need one. And then we will build some concrete walls around it. Okay, before I go any further, the staff room, and once I can find it, that has to be 4x4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to do 4x6. That should be fine. And then we'll have the infirmary. It's just going to be this little section there. And then we will put a staff door in here. And that will get changed to a staff door as well. So that will be where our... and we've just did a little bit wrong there. Concrete wall. Okay. So our staff, when they want some get feel a bit tired, they'll only have to go here instead of all the way down. Right, are you actually building this here? Okay, let's just put a door in here just to make sure that you start building this. Also a marker for where everything is going to be going to. Right, how's the rest of our prison going? Where did we find it? We didn't find it. Let's give a new thing. Okay, you guys search that cell, but I like searching when they're asleep. I know it's may not be the best time, but I find them when they've got all their little dummy heads and everything showing. So to me, that's a good idea. Now these guys, no, we won't have them. Now you can see they're quite well lit up here, so we should be able to see any dummies, and they should be able to detect that before they start digging out. Now this is the aim of this, so we are active. We've also got our little phone tap is active. If I go to utilities, you can see if I go show wires on here. Where are we? Show wires. We can see all of our wires. So our phone tap is connected to these two. And the CCTV is on all of the cameras quite nicely. And our door control system. So that's all quite cool. That's 4x5. So we will be putting these into these areas. We need these foundations. So what we'll do now is hopefully these guys are working on these foundations. We have a load of people. What are they? What? Let's just see if they are going to be working on these foundations at any time soon. We're still doing a lot of. Oops. Let's see. Yeah, it's still got it there. They are queued. So we just have to wait. So what I'll do is quickly fast forward this to the point they start building those up. Because I need those foundations in next. Although what we can do is set the other part, which was over here. Although I have done one part in that wall, I haven't done the other part. And we can also work out what else do we need. Now, we've got two more rooms here, which are going to end up being created. So let's say I might make this one. What other sections do we need? We need parole. Let's make this the parole room for the maximum security. Because what rooms have we got? We've got a parole, is one. A library I would like to get in, because that would be fine. We've got common rooms, although I haven't put any items in there. We've got visitation. Let's start at the top. Let's start at the top, make a way through. So canteens got, kitchens got, showers, yes, yard. Don't need deliveries, any of those. Workshop. So we're going to have a workshop. One of these will be the workshop. Security rooms, yes, we've got those. Office, don't need. Infirmary, yes, we will now have an infirmary. Common rooms, they've got those. Laundry. Now we could get them working in a laundry. So we got one of these could be the laundry, one the workshop. Yeah, okay, that sounds like a good idea. Cleaning cupboard. That's the other possibility. That's only needs to be a small room to be a cleaning cupboard. That's another possibility. Anything else? Library. So the only two ones that we haven't specifically got is going to be cleaning cupboard and library. Okay, now let's just think this through. How big has the parole room got to be? 5x5. I'm just trying to see if I can make something dual purpose. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now it uses up, you can't split it into being parole and visitor. So at the moment that's visitor, but maybe we could make this parole instead. Whoa, we have a fight going on. We've got one dead and a few unconscious. Obviously, someone was not happy there. Someone got taken out. Is that... He was a snitch. That's why he got taken out, I'm guessing. Right, he's injured. I'm going to send him up to the holding cell. And why are you in here? You and you should not be in there. Yeah, why is maximum security in here still? That's just wrong. There's something not right here. Why did some maximum security guys get into these showers? So I can't, because as far as I'm concerned, you should have gone in the showers here. Why are you down here? Or was it a graphical glitch? Because I can't see them anymore. I don't know. Right, he's being taken away now, these two. But, yeah, why were they there? That's a little, worrying. Right, there's no prisoners assigned to, but you should be going here. Let's just have a look here at logistics. Okay, that's in Supermax. There we go. Let's remove that. Unfortunately, these were not. I'd obviously hit a Supermax instead of a Max. Okay, this yard. There's a gap there. I need to get this. Constructed as soon as I can. Okay, so we were working on some of this. Just fill in some of these objects in here for this staff room. So what would they need for the staff room? They need a wide sofa and a drink machine. We'll put a wide sofa up there. We'll put a TV in here as well. And where's the drinks machine? And we need a drink machine. Up at the corner over there. That looks fine. That should be enough for them. They don't need too much. And the common rooms. What do they need in a common room? Common room. Objects. What should we give them? We'll give them let's give them a TV. They can have a TV in each of the common rooms. There we go. And they can have one sofa. There we go. And, one chair. I'm not giving them too much. I mean, crikey. Okay, we've got some good, got some movement here now. Is excellent. Now, one thing, I wasn't able to put perimeter over the top here, so I might have to just put a bit of fencing in here. Let's see. I'm going to have to put a where's perimeter wall? I'll put one, that one in there. And then possibly like that as well. There we go. Because the perimeter wall, forever, I can't go over the top of the electrical plant. Nicking power drills? Clikey. Can't trust anyone nowadays. So our parole room is the one, is one area we have an issue in, that we are not, haven't got a parole room specifically for here, but we could fit that into this section potentially. So if we do the chapel next down here, just to get this chapel done. Now that needs to be 6x6, so if we just make it like that, and then we'll just put in the concrete wall up top. Now we will have a camera in here. That is going to be a priority. And I always forget which way around the cameras go. The cameras go with... which way do the cameras go? Yeah. Square bit is at the back. Okay, we're putting a camera in here. We don't put two cameras here. Yeah, one camera will be enough. And we will put a door. Just a normal door, just here. Excellent. Okay, so that will be the chapel. And to be a chapel, it needs a few certain objects. It needs a altar. Where's the pews? One. Spray and a altar. Just there, and see some prayer mats. I'm sure they can use that as carpeting or something. Okay, anything else? That should be fine. So that will resolve that one as well. So what else have we got left? So this leaves this area, which we could use for that, those parole. Although parole needed 5x5 from memory. Let's have a check. So maybe we'll change this to parole and that to visitation. Let's have a look. How many squares have we got here? 1, 2, 3. We've got 4 squares. Excellent. That's that done. We've got 4 squares available, and I think the parole room needed more than 4. Annoyingly, I think the parole room's 5x5, which is, you know, so that doesn't have a requirement, so that could go in there, and we could have cleaning and a few other bits and pieces. But where are we? Can I see it when I need it? Can I? Bollocks. Parole. 5x5, yeah, typical bloody 5x5. Why does it have to be 5x5? Other options. The staff room is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's 4. That's... yeah. And you can't get out anymore, can you? You have to wait for that door to be put in there. Okay, we'll see what we're going to use that for next. We've got this area to have a work on first. So, these sections are 1, 2, 3... yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4. They're 5x5 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5x5 inside. One, two, three, four, five. Put this down to there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put across there, and the same here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we don't want the bit just in there. That's fine. Here the same. No, I'm way out on my sizing here. So we're going opposites. So that goes in one just there. Not there, not there. Across there. And this one comes down two. I have, let's cancel this for a second, because I'm not exactly symmetrical here for some reason. Let's just work out my sizing. Is it because this has ended up being a shared wall, so we've got a little extra here? Because that should be the door there, and that's got to go there, which means this should go like that, and this door should actually be here. And this concrete wall. So we've actually gained some size. This side will be slightly larger than the other side. Okay, that's fine. We can use it for something else, such as life. They've gained a little size. Concrete wall there. We will dismantle that door. There we go. Concrete walls. And we will need, let's see, where are we going to go through? Let's start duplicating cloning. We can use the clone tool now to clone some of these areas. Let's first of all, I'm going to clone this corner, and then just clone this part of it. 1, 2. Am I right somewhere? Yep, I am right. Then we'll do the same for this section. One, two, three, four. Looks good. And then one more time here. Quick bit of cloney. And then finally down the bottom. So it's a regular pattern, nothing unusual. I'd hope to do some, I think I explained in the other video, I'd hope to do some weird sort of shapes, and it just didn't really work, unfortunately. Certainly not as I would like it to work. Just didn't look right, quite simply. So, okay, that's opposite those. That's cool. Right, we will make room for the common rooms. That's there. Showers. That's showers in the center. And the common rooms are here. All nice and symmetrical. Because we like it to be symmetrical. We're getting good visibility. Nothing's being done without us seeing it in general, which is good. Have we now got the correct deployment? No, we haven't got the correct... There we go. That's better. Right, staff only around here. MaxSec there. That's going to be staff only. And MaxSec only. So, okay, that should give them access here. I'll make this all MaxSec as well. Okay, I need a bit of fencing down here just to block that off. Then I can make this a yard. So we're okay here to a degree. Concrete wall just in there. And, that's ready to be constructed. Right, utilities. We need to get some electrical cable down here. So, straight down the center. And then there. There. That should satisfy those. Now we also need to worry about... Let's see, we've got the servos there. We're going to need... working out. We got various items. We're going to need some down here as well. The various, make sure they have power available to them for the remote doors. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to clone the security area, because effectively I want exactly the same everything that is here. Except maybe those, I won't put the servos in there. But all of those put into here. It's actually going to be slightly larger. So I can extend the security zoning here a little bit. Security. There we go. Now we did have, one of these should be a... take that one out there, and we're going to make a solitary door just here. There we go. Anywhere else I need doors? A door there, which is fine. Oh yeah, metal detectors. A metal detector. Metal detector. Where's the metal detector? There we are. We will put one just here. And also the entrance to... as they go back to the cell block, they will get us those. Right, where do I need more cameras? Cameras just here. Objects. CCTV. One there. One there. And on the insides of the canteen. Now, which one shall I have as canteens? Oh, these are both canteens, so... one there. 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 And there. There we go. Cameras in there, ready to be able to find out what's going on in those in that area. Excellent. I think we'll make, yes, we'll make one canteen here. Right, now we're going to get ready with the servos. Before we do the doors in, I'm going to put all the servos in first. So, we select a door servo from, where are we? We're at door servo here. And what we're going to work out, we're going to need one just, let's see. We'll need one just there. We'll need one just here. There. 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 That's five door servos. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 door servos. Oh, shit. We've had an escape. Oh, dear. Looks like someone managed to get through. That's not good. I've been concentrating on our system and not been doing my shakedowns. And basically the usual cell block searches. Okay, we have to get some done now, but it looks like we've just lost somebody. That's not good. That's a bad penalty. Yes, yeah, okay. We're going to have to remove tunnels. There's going to be a tunnel from somewhere around here. One of these, looks like we've got a dummy here. This looks like this guy here. Dummy, yeah. Booger. More searches needed, basically. Lot more searches. They dig damn quickly now, it seems. So certainly not as not very effective. My stopping them the buggers digging out. We should find it here when they suddenly go into this cell block here. Come on. Find that tunnel. What do you mean you haven't found the tunnel? There's already... I know it's there. Oh. Okay, so this is that one thing. I know it's there. So let's search this. Because there's a friggin' dummy here, so it's got to be there. Surely. Come on. Look. Maybe on the second attempt he will get it. There's obviously a chance of finding or not finding the tunnel. Ah, see, that this time he found it. First time, they didn't find it. So it's not guaranteed to find that tunnel every time. I don't know if that's correct or not. But certainly a problem. So even though we had searched it previously, potentially maybe we hadn't searched it enough. Now, you can use shakedowns, which does the whole prison, but I think that might be a little bit too much. But certainly these ones on the end, the closer you are to the external, you need a bit more searching, a little bit more often. And we didn't search anyone in here. I think it's this block's turn. Yep, that cell block. I tend to pick one cell block each time, just to give them little bit of evenness. Why are the utilities here? Okay, yes, yes, I remember now. Right, I've got to... Because of the, we've got a thick wall here, our thick pipe is not going all the way through here. So we need to... Let's try putting that in there, see if that will give these some needed water. Because we've got perimeter wall up here. The water won't go far enough. Now, I need, while I'm in that utilities, let's sort out the utilities I need in here. Which is going to be along there. Along there. There. And here. And I'm going to deconstruct that one there. I don't need that. Do I need that heavy wall there? Okay, maybe not, maybe not. Let's run that round the side. And we're gonna need some more pipe in there. Which one's the shower? Oh dear, brain's working, not working. Which one was gonna be shower? Shower's the one at the top. Okay, shower just here. There. And while we're about it, let's put the shower bits in. Then I won't have a question in the future as to which one is the shower. Excellent, okay. Now, because they've put some of these jail doors in, we are needing people in here. Okay, so we've got that fairly much built with a few decisions as to what to use for some of these buildings here. Disappointed that they managed to get someone tunneling out again. Very annoying. But he's waiting for a hearse by the looks of it. Dead body sitting in the road waiting to be picked up by the looks of it. It's interesting they handcuff the dead bodies. I've got to say, that's a little unusual. When we come back, I'm going to push it through to finish off this section. Because the next stage I want to do on the next one is actually bring some more max security people in. So that we can actually see if we can get some gang members. Because just at the moment, I don't think we have any gangs. We don't have any gangs. We might get some in if I bring some more max security people into our prison. So, as always, let me know in the comments all the crappy things I did that I should have done or you think would be better. And I'll see if I can either pull them in or make the changes as required. Hopefully it's some of the it's interesting some of the parts with the way that you have to watch out and look out for various items. Such as access when you block off certain sections. You can't truly have everything segregated. You've got to have them split to a certain degree. So, this, which is good, which is fine. It's just one of those things you have to take into account when building your prison. Maybe it would be better in the future to either have a central area with all the shared areas or have avenues which are from the various sections to the secure area, corridor as such. There's a couple of possible options there. So one of those things I forgot or did not take into account when we started this prison. For the moment though, please click that like button down below. Just let me know people are watching it. Keep an eye out for your own prisons. Keep playing, but most of all, have fun.